What's going on, print on demand sellers? It's your friend Jack, and today we're going to be taking a look at 5 websites that you can go to get free SVG images. They're all under the public domain, meaning you can just use them on your artwork, on all types of things commercially, and make a profit off them because they are not restricted, right? So these websites are great resources. I've been using them since I started print on demand. I have found some more over time. However, a couple of them I've been using since the early days of print on demand, going back to the first month of me doing print on demand. I found a few of these websites and I found them very helpful along the way, especially when I want to grab a simple graphic image and put it with my text-based designs. I love going to these websites and using them. They're absolutely free and legal, so make sure you guys stick around and view all these 5 websites because I definitely think they will help in your t-shirt design game and it won't get you in any trouble. All right, so the first website we're on here, it is called PX Here, and it is a really good website. It is basically more photography. However, all of these images are under the copyright or the public domain copyright, meaning you can use them, and pretty much all of them, they will say if you need to give them attribution or not, if you can use them commercially. So if we want to do an example, we're just going to do dog for pretty much all of our examples because we want to stick to see, you know, what type of different images these offer. There's a filter for NSFW if you want to have that on or off. It's an interesting filter. And there's also some filters up here. You can search by the color grade or the types of colors you want in your images, which is really good. So obviously you can do that. It is really nice. And you can also change the size. You can put the sizes you want. You can also change if you want the latest ones or the most popular. I'm gonna stick to popular. And then you can also basically find the one you want. Obviously we changed the color, so this dog is looking a little bit weird, but nonetheless, it's still a great photo. And if we wanna click it, you can see right here in the top right that there is a public domain CC0 on it. I'm not sure what that stands for, copyright something, but free for personal use and commercial use. Commercial meaning you can sell it on t-shirts and no attribution required. You can click on the learn more to see that it actually is an official basically image in the public domain. However, you can also change the size of it. So you can go up to, for this image, 2560 by 1440, which is a really high resolution photo. Obviously there's a free original download. You just click that button, bam, download it. And you can also put it for Android, iOS. You can do lots of things on this. So you can go to this website on your phone and download images. So if you're someone who makes designs on your phone, this website's a great resource. Once again, I really like this website. And let's go back and let's search for cat. Why not? Because this website is actually really good. And, you know, we got some big cats here. But once again, look how high quality these images are. This cat looks pretty cool. And when we go onto it, once again, free for public and commercial use, no attribution required. And it even shows the camera it's written on, the colors that are included in the image, and tags. So it's really easy to find things you actually want on here because they have a tag system. This website I haven't used as much because it's more photography based. However, it's really good to get good photography based photos from, that you can basically crop out the animal, crop out the image, or use for things like masks or like wall art. It's really good for those things. Obviously you should make some type of alteration to it. You shouldn't just be uploading just the design or just the photo, because, you know, that's not really something you should do. Even if it's in the public domain, you want to alter it in some way, make your own flair to it, give it your own spin. And with that being said, let's go to the next website. So here we are over on Raw Pixel, and there is a lot of things on this website. But if you go to public domain right here, you can search in the public domain for whatever you want, and you're going to see already there's a lot more like drawing type images and SVG type based things. So we're going to go cat, you know. And when we go cat, you're going to see, look at these images are really good for t-shirt designs in comparison to photographs, because you can easily crop them out. They're more hard lines than actual photographs. Some of them are very realistic. However, putting these on t-shirts with like text actually suits really well, especially when you find the right text. Things like this are really good. So if we click on this image, public domain CC0 image, free use, and you can get the original size, which is quite big. Big enough, and free unlimited downloads for a public domain collection. You just click this button, you can download it. You have 2 different size options, so not as much sizing options. It is a JPG, JPEG, and you can basically just erase all of this with Photoshop or whatever you want to do and add some text to it and make a good design. And you're not limited to just this. You have a lot of options, I believe. It doesn't say the amount of results, but you can change a lot of filters here. PSD, PNG, vectors. So if we click on vectors, there's no results for vectors in the public domain. However, PSDs, JPGs, PNGs, there's lots of images, right? So there's lots of definitely resources that are absolutely free, public domain, commercial use that you can use on this website. And because I'm sharing with you guys five websites, the beauty of it is you don't have to stick to just one. Basically, I have all five of these bookmarked, and if I can't find what I want on one of them, I'll just go to the other one, and pretty much 99% of the time I'm gonna find something that I can use or that I like. And oftentimes I am overloaded with things I like and that I can use because there are a lot of free resources on these websites. I think they often go overlooked, and the fact that you can just scroll here for, you know, 157 results on this one website for these cats, and a lot of these images are very, very, very usable, especially for t-shirt designs, and they fit really well, especially with certain design types are going to do better with your kind of preference and your ideas of what you want to make. However, there's lots of options on here, and with that being said, let's go to the third website. So the third website is actually the first website that I ever used in the history of public domain vectors. Funny enough, it's called publicdomainvectors.org, and this is because, you know, this one comes up pretty much instantly, or it comes up pretty frequently when you search for public domain vectors, because that's the direct name of it. But if we search up cat here, these images are very, very, friendly for t-shirts and things, because they are literally SVGs. You can change almost every element of most of them. We have all type, but you can change just sort by SVGs, or you can show more. And this is sort by date, but you can also sort by the amount of downloads it has. And when I scroll down here, I'm gonna see a couple images in this section. I've used this before, I've used this image, I've used multiple of these images in my t-shirt designs. And I can tell you right now, I have made images with this cat right here that sold. And obviously I'm not gonna tell you niche, not gonna tell you exactly what I did, but I have made images with that cat and they sold. So if I can do it with just that cat right there, then I'm sure that you can make designs with all these awesome graphic images that are literally meant for t-shirts. Like, these are pretty much meant for t-shirts, coloring books, all that type of thing. They are cartoony, not all of them are cartoony, but they are very like strong lines. They aren't like gradients, so they're very useful for things like t-shirts. This one looks really awesome, and all you have to do is click download once again under the public domain vector, and that's the license. If you click on it, it actually brings you to the Creative Commons. So no copyright on this work, and there is a actual like thing for it that tells you that it's not copyrighted, that it's free, free to use basically, which is really awesome. And there's no attribution required, which is another awesome thing. So this is another website that I highly recommend. Let's go take a look at a few more things on the website, and then we'll move on to the fourth website. So as you can see here on the search bar, 65,000 vector images in the public domain. So they have a collection of about 65,000, which is pretty crazy. And real quick, I want to search up dog as well, and things like cat and dog on here have like 7 pages of results, so they have a lot more than the other sites. And these aren't all relevant, however a lot of them, I mean some of them are hot dogs, but it still is related to the keyword, so it's pretty funny. But a lot of them are really high quality things like this like golden retriever, a lot of high quality sketches that sell really well on designs that they don't look cheap, right? They look pretty good, but they're under the public domain, meaning you can use them, and they're absolutely free, which is just something that is quite surprising that all this stuff is free. Obviously, if you see something that is too good to be true, sometimes there can be trademarked images on the public domain vector. And when I say trademarked, I mean like sometimes you'll see like a logo or something like that. So definitely proceed with caution on things like that. However, most of the time, all of these things are gonna be perfectly fine. They just look really cool, especially these ones. I think these look awesome, and literally they're free. So I just want to show you that. I want to show you some more results on this website because there are a lot of results. 7 pages for just dogs, and all of them look really good. And with that being said, I want to move on to the fourth website, which is actually the second website that I found when I was doing public domain research. So here we are over on Free SVG, and right now when we go to the home page, we're gonna see that it's very similar to the last one we checked out. However, I found that this one is a lot similar to public domain vectors. usually have everything they do over there and more, which is actually quite surprising. They don't have all the exact same things, but it's very similar. So if we type dog, we're probably gonna find that, you know, a lot of these are the same. Yes, they are. And instead of 7 pages, there's 20 pages. So this website is probably my favorite, I'd say, in total. This is the one I've used the most. Most of the things over on free public domains are on free SVG. However, it does not hurt to check both. I definitely still would recommend checking out both. And lots of more dog images. It's a very similar website in terms of tags. And there always is these little advertisements for Shuttershock, because obviously they gotta make money from running this website. So these aren't actually free. You can't use these ones at the top, but you can use the 20 pages that they do have of some pretty awesome dog images. Same hot dogs, obviously we've seen on the other one, and a lot of the same images, but nonetheless, there's still so many options on here, and that's why I want to share all the websites with you guys. There are some great tools that you can put on your t-shirts, and just the more resources that you have for images, vector images, the better. And some of these dogs look like awesome, right? Some of these I think by themselves would sell t-shirts. You just write some text with them, a funny joke, and you have a best-selling design right there. And you didn't have to pay $30 for a graphic image or someone to illustrate for you, which is really awesome. Now we are onto the last website, which is publicdomainpictures.net, and this website is actually really good too. I'm going to search up cat right here, and you can see we can search by recommended, relevancy, popularity, rating, and date. And when we go down here and we click on something like these cat silhouettes, which look really good, you can choose to PayPal the owner of the design. However, they have released it under the public domain and offered a free download right here. And you can just click right here, you can see the license, and you can click right here, free download, and then you have the image and you can right click, save it, and you have it under the public domain so you can use it. Obviously, you shouldn't just upload the image that is here, and you should actually alter it in some way, take something from it and add to it, right? So keep that in mind when you're using these images. You don't wanna just post a picture of the silhouette and call it a day. That's not what you can't do that really. More or less people have already done that, or the owner doesn't want you to do that. They put it here so you can alter it, modify it, and make it better and use it as a resource rather than just using it, right? So you actually add to it. That's the idea with all the public domain websites. And that's the final website. There's not much more to it than that. They're all very similar, but they all have different resources that are pulling from the public domain. So there's lots of options that are going to come up for each one that are different. So that's why I listed 5 different websites, so you guys can use each of them to find the images that you want and incorporate them in your designs, on your t-shirts, and make them better for free, $0. And yeah, that's the 5 websites, not 10, just 5. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please smash the like button. It would mean the world to me. And if you made it to this point of the video, comment down below, free SVG, free SVG. And I'll see you guys in the next video. It's been your friend Jack. Keep striving, stay blessed. See you later.